Hey, YouTubers! Well, it's DeBoer, Star Trek Enterprise refit update number 8. Moving along. And goes to show you that the VIP lounge is still being worked on. Even a little tiny detail like that can take several days to, you know, configure, work out. Especially right now, I'm almost in like R&D. The DeBoer kit's not like the Polar Lights. I've never built it before. So it's a slow process. You know, some things will go faster, big sections go faster. But little tiny details like the shuttle bay and the VIP lounge and whatever else I come up with, the Arboretum, are slow going. You know, tedious little task. However, I'm going to show you finishing up the VIP today. I did get the figures in from China. The figures are $8. The shipping was $39. But I got it within a few days. Traveled a heck of a long way. And I'll get you a look at this. But I'll try to give you a better look. It's very hard to focus in on these. These guys have full uniforms. And I actually have a little spot of gold where their insignias are. So I'm really proud of that. My eyes hurt and I would have blind and mad, but I got them. So, and then we'll have more of them in the shuttle bay, but I got one sitting down at a table, a couple security guards. And for some reason, I've never felt right using the modern colors of the uniforms, the tans, whatever. They just don't stand out. So one of my little signatures is to always use original series shirt colors. So you can say, well, there's a red shirt, there's a blue shirt, there's and all that. So my crew guys always have the original series colors. Just a little quirk of mine. I know, oh, it's not canon and all that. I like it. And no client has complained about it yet. Also, my good friend Elliot Brown. My God, Elliot, you need to move close by and, you know, and I'll adopt you or something. Has come up very graciously. And this is actually the second set. We've been kind of eyeballing and doing, you know, pencil impressions and all that without me having to send the whole kit in now, which is impossible since it's got a lot of goop and crap on it. I don't know exactly what. What is this stuff, Elliot? Wow. Very cool. I'll have to ask. I'm not sure what that is. Oh, that's like an inner ring. Anyways, so Elliot being able to, I suppose he does these laser etched or something, but he whips them out fast. God. And that's warmplastic.com for you guys that would like to employ Elliot Brown for your modeling services. And I think, if I can remember, and I'm having a heck of a time learning to do captions and things like that on Adobe Premiere, but I'll figure it out. But right here should be www.warmplastic.com. And this is what he's whipped up for me, and I hope this thing's focusing. Yeah, these are the VIP lounge windows. Notice there are, what is it? It's like four different varieties with different sizes on the side and shapes. And what we're trying to do is find the best shape in size for this DeBoer's. I suppose after enough homework and time, we'll have, you know, a good grip on what's required to make a, you know, a laser etch brass augment set for the DeBoer's. So Dennis, if you're listening, you might want to call me. You know, I don't think anybody else has done it, and in time I will have, you know, some of the primary pieces, the frames for the Arboretum, for the VIP lounge. I've already got the frames worked out for the docking ports. I've got the frames that really work nicely in those little segments up on the bridge. We're slowly building a little kit here, I think. So anyway, Dennis, if you're interested, call me. You know the number. It's on the website. What else? Oh, big news. Latest transmission from outer space. No, it's not Elmo. No, it's not Trek Nazi. I guess you could say, drum roll, it's Wrath of the Professor, Part 3. As you know, the Professor is zooming off in space and destroyed Monkey's ship. Well, what happened after that? What could it be? You'll find out at the end of this film. Oh, sounds familiar. But anyways, so what we're going to go over is what's going on right now. I'm going to show you a little bit more of me working on the VIP lounge, putting in the little shrubbery. I'm adding the little men, trying to get you a look at the men, but boy, they are so tiny. They're bigger than the 1/350ths now, mind you. They're about 1/3 bigger, but not much bigger. But definitely, you know, the 1/350ths were too small. These are perfect. So, let's move on. Okay, so here's our basic layout right now. We've got a little, what was it, model railroad tree thing. No, it's not what you guys in California think it is. No, I didn't get it at the dispensary. It's not medical grade or anything like that. Stop it. Just stop it. All right. So here's our little VIP loungy thing. Notice now it's been pretty much completed, and I will go in on closing up on it in a moment. I want to try and see if you can get close to seeing what these little guys look like. And yes, I need a manicure. It's hard for me to say, is it in focus or not at this point? There's sort of the Spock character kind of guy. Well, no, actually, that'd be the captain kind of guy. This little guy here, is this the one I'm thinking of? Yeah, the little blue guy, the more the Spocky character. And again, I'm trying to get this thing to focus. Is carrying some gold equipment cases. I don't know if you can see that or not. And there's one of those red shirt security guys I was telling you about. So these guys are going to be in the lounge. A couple security personnel, Spock and Kirk having a discussion, you know, something like that. Let's see. So I think at this point, I think I've got this thing rigged. Yeah, there we go. Let's see if I got my centering good. I want to get you as close as possible here. And I'm gonna try to keep it centered so you can see what's going on. Nice optics. All right. So what I got here is the room is done. Notice that now I've raised it because you couldn't quite make out the rear wall detail. It was actually originally a little bit longer, and then I cut it down. But when I realized after I cut it down, because I wanted to even out with the wall sections, it wasn't quite right. The ports on the side were a little short. And it would have left a lot of light gap. So what I did is I rebuilt it, but I rebuilt it with the light block. There's black material on the outside of here, black material on this side here, so that if you're looking at it, it'll look like the ceilings, you know, where all the ducting work and all that are slightly different color than the rest of the room. It'll be interesting, trust me. It'll be an interesting point. You won't see the white, but if you do, it'll look like just a hint of where the, you know, the technical stuff is, where the conduits and pipes, whatever. Because remember, this is a spaceship. It's not a pleasure cruiser. I have, with my handy-handy little hand vise, pen vise, I put two little indents where I would like the greenery to be. I mean, it could have been flagpoles too, but I kind of like the green to break up all the, you know, the light colors and the fact that the VIP lounge had a little greenery. It just kind of unifies it for me. Flagpoles would be pretty obscure, be like, you know, a pin with the cut down with a little piece of, you know, red or blue material on it. It would be hard to make out at this scale. So what we're gonna do is I'm going to do a little cutaway here, and I'm going to cut a little bit of this off, plant it in there, and show you now with the trees going on. All right, so now I put a little epoxy on here. And what we're gonna do is go in and install that other little tree to that little hole. They have to hold them down because they're still a little sticky from the sealer. There you go. Gotta keep an eye on them as the epoxy dries. Make sure he's in about the right place. So I find him a little close to the shelf in proportion to the other one. So I'm actually going to move them a little bit this way to keep the proportions more accurate. Let's see. I want the spacing to be the same or very similar. Of course, he's a tree, he's not a freaking module. Same thing with this guy. There we go. Pretty. Two different ones, slightly different colors, makes it look interesting. All right. So let's see, let me get a decent view of this for you. There you go. The little tree. Let's see if I can move it a little bit without affecting the little tree. In the back. See? All right, so now we're going to start adding little guys. And let me prep them guys, and we'll get going on that. So here you go. Now we've got our little trees in place. We've got our characters in place. It's you know, nicely done. It's very neat and clean. Of course, some of the exterior edges look raw and all that, but of course you won't be seeing that. That's behind the scenes. What we're concerned about is what's going to be seen through the glass. And when I install it and all that, which I might include in this film, let's see, we, you know, been running a while here, and the day is getting short, but let me see if I can actually put it inside, light block it, the upper saucer, and let you see what it looks like from the window outside. Moving on. Okay, here's the VIP lounge installed. Mostly installed. I haven't really sealed it in permanent yet, but it is bonded in there at 3 points, so I can at least do this. Now, I'm going to try to keep this thing in focus, but it's difficult. It needs to keep focusing on my finger, and I think we're beyond focus length here. Come on, buddy. Right about there. There you go. So you can see the two guys in the back, the trees, the fellow sitting down. And I'm going to lower the table a bit and give you another angle. But these things are so tiny, it's really hard to make them out on camera for some reason. Here's a nice view. Looking down, you can see the personages in there. And I don't know if I can like get closer, guys. Yeah, see, at this point, I start reaching a limit of my focus. Because I am really, really pushing it. There you go. Now I'm going to try a lower angle so you can see up on the wall. Hopefully you can see the spotlight. Alright, let's cut here. Alright, last attempt. Now, I'm going to try to close up on here. You can see the Starfleet or Federation. Ooh, right about there's the limit. Up on the wall. You can see the light shining up on it and the characters. It's a really cool view. I haven't installed the frame yet, which will cut down on the refraction and all that. Remember, this is glass here. I am getting some reflection and things like that. But all that will be sorted with. Pretty cool. Wish I could give you a better view, and I will with the camera stills. I have more control over it than the video camera. But I hope you enjoyed it. Now, Wrath of the Professor Part 3. Hang on to your comm chair. More next week, guys. Take care.
I'm not touching. You're touching me.
I am not touching you.
What are you touching me? What have you got?
I'm not like my being touched.
I am touching you. Against your butt. You're touching me.
All right, what?
I'm touching you.
Everybody, stop talking for this 1 minute.
You're touching me.
Gosh, I can't believe this. This is unbelievable. The heck is my escape pod?
Captain?
Mm-hmm. What? What is it, Jack?
Well, I was just wondering.
Yes? What is it?
What happened to Attila and Philbert anyway?
I don't know. I do not know what happened to them. I do not know where they are. All I know is, I said all hands abandon ship, head to the escape pod, and it wasn't there, and this is all we got.
Gosh, Captain, it's just really cramped in here, and I mean, we've been floating in here for days.
I know, but look, maybe we can land on a planet somewhere and, you know, build a new spaceship or something. Something will happen. We're gonna get through this. Okay. Alright. Everybody just calm down.
Captain?
Yes? What is it, Larry?
I have a confession to make.
Yes?
You know, well, I ate a lot of those beans before, well, you know, just before the battle.
Mm-hmm. And?
What about it?
Oh gosh, that was disgusting. Oh my god, Chase. That's so stinky.
I can't believe this.
If you just...
Oh, it's stinky.
I'm sorry. It's stinky.
God.
I can't believe it.
This is not happening. This is not happening to me. Ugh. We have got to find a planet to land on. We're gonna have to build a new spaceship. We're gonna find Attila, and we're gonna find Philbear, and then what, Captain? And then I'm going to find Manfred. And you know what? What, Captain? When I find Manfred, oh my goodness gracious me. He is going to rue the day that he ever met the monkey. I tell you, it's going to be a bad day. Yeah. Gosh, it's sticking here. I'm sorry I farted. I had a lot of beans. Alright. Well, enough's enough. Look, there's a planet over there. So, let's all lean over that way, and maybe we can make our way.
Say, Attila.
Yes, Philbear?
You know this escape pod that we're in?
Yep.
Do you notice anything strange
about it?
What do you mean?
Well, what? Well, where is everybody? Yeah, that's a good point. I mean, it's a spacious, well-equipped escape pod, lots of food, comfy blankets and beds and pillows, lots of milk, cookies, ice cream, popcorn, everything you need to survive an emergency. Except, the captain and the rest of the guys, they're just not here. I noticed that too. You don't suppose that, we blasted off the escape pod without him, do ya? Oh jeez. Oh gosh. Oh man, are we gonna get it? Oh boy. Let's... Trying to make our way back, see if we can find those guys. Oh gosh, Captain's gonna be pissed. Yep, sure is.